File entry recipe number 2 consists in making existing indexes unusable. Whenever you search a key in an index, it's very similar to your searching a word in a dictionary. The database server compares what it finds in the tree nodes to the key being searched and descends of the tree according to comparison between what is searched and the value found in the current node. Just like you move backwards and forwards in the dictionary depending on the first and last words on a page. The word you search is like the index key. Now, if I give you a dictionary, ask you to find the number of the page where the word rill is located, it's a question that is very similar to this SQL query. Suppose now that the dictionary is an English-French dictionary. If I ask you to find the page where to find the word that translates to rue in French, you are at a loss because you can no longer browse the dictionary. The only option left is to start reading the dictionary from A to Z and check the translation of all words. You will never do it, but a database server will, and this happens as soon as you apply a function to an index column that you want to search. What you will do though, and this is what you should do in SQL 2, is go to the English-French part of the dictionary, find the translation of U in English, and then use the word found to do a regular search. Applying functions at the wrong place is a very common mistake, particularly with dates. Tried and true recipe number 3 is to hardcode everything. All products don't behave exactly the same in this respect, but if you want to hit Oracle particularly hard, this is a very good idea. When SQL queries are built by program and simple concatenation, what happens when the value of an identifier changes? For the DBMS, it's a brand new query and it goes through analysis, often called parsing, and the optimizer recomputes an execution plan using a lot of CPU in the process. This is a very simple Oracle PLSQL example to show the extent of damages. In the first example, I execute repeatedly a query by concatenating the value of the ID that identifies the row to return to the statement. It doesn't run for ages, but the important thing to note is that the elapsed time is all CPU time, and parsing represents about 2/3 of it. In the second example, I execute the same query but pass the value of the identifier as a parameter. The result is that parsing has dropped to something negligible, and we divide the runtime by a factor 2.5 for the very same process. It is so obvious an improvement that both Oracle and Microsoft have done something to try and fix poorly written code. You can ask the SQL engine to force, more or less aggressively, the translation of constant values to parameters so that queries are passed only once. But the problem is with the distribution of data. When your main criterion is something like an indexed status indicator, which is usually very unevenly distributed, you may have cases where the value that is passed is very common and not selective at all. And other cases, where the value is very rare and very selective. In such a case, you don't want all constants to be replaced by parameters. Because if you have statistics telling the frequency of the different values, it is very easy to have the optimizer derailed. It will have to choose, for instance, between using an index on a date, which will be best for common values, and using an index on the status, which is the best for infrequent values. For many databases, the choice of the execution plan depends on the first parameter value that is met. It can cause plan instability and queries that run fast in the morning and slowly in the afternoon, if the query has been reparsed with the wrong parameters in between. In such a case, what you really want is to have two different statements that will execute differently. Tried and true recipe number 4 is to abuse procedural database accesses. In my experience, it is no longer big bad SQL queries that are the biggest performance issue. Missing indexes are also, for the most part, a thing of the past. Actually, many tables I come across are over-indexed. Most performance issues today are with too many fast or moderately fast queries. If you take a look at the following procedure, for instance, found in production, there is no reason to insert data, then update what has just been inserted. It is very easy to insert the right data directly. But I think that what explains the issue best is to show you weekend shopping, as I believe it is practiced by most developers. First, they jump into their car. Then they drive a little, until they arrive at the supermarket. At this point, there is something of an orientation run among the shelves of the various departments, until they find what they want, then head for the cashier, drive back home, store the milk into the fridge, then start again for the next item on the shopping list. This is exactly the way most programs use databases. Where things become really funny is when you consider the cures that are usually recommended. First, black magic. Here you have a DBA in traditional DBA garb performing the magical parameter dance. Then you hear suggestions such as, we need some more powerful hardware, we need more bandwidth, we must tune the search query, or we should try and improve IOs. All of this will improve speed, somewhat, but is it the issue really? Well, I don't think so. Just keep in mind that unitary processing kills. Tried and true recipe number 4.5 is to put user functions everywhere. Why 4.5? Because actually it's a procedural variant. I am going to take an example that talks to everyone, money. Suppose we want to convert a certain amount from a foreign currency into our own currency. We can write a function that takes the amount and the currency, then queries the table that holds currency rates and returns the value converting to the last known exchange rate. The query in the function is extremely fast. If I run this query against a 2 million row table, it becomes awfully slow. I am cheating a bit here. I got my result in a little over 9 minutes. I rewrote the function and brought the elapsed time down to 1 minute and 16 seconds, an improvement by a factor of more than 7. How did I do it? My magic touch. Actually, even a big international bank deals in very few currencies. You will have the local currency, the currencies of the main trade partners, then dollars, euros, British pounds, yens and the like. It's always the same values, and if you call the function to retrieve thousands of times the exchange rates with the same currency, you are doing a lot of useless work. So what I did is that I used session variables as cache to store the various exchange rates, as I was referencing them, fetching each one only once to reduce the number of calls to the SQL engine. If you think the result is awesome, think twice. If you use a simple join, it's usually faster than the improve function, and it's even more striking with Oracle and SQL Server than with MySQL. For the optimizer, a function is a black box, and you have a lot of context switches between the regular execution of a statement and the function call. It's, at a micro level, another case of chatty application, not unlike the shopping algorithm you have seen.